Now, early in the program, we saw how supermarkets are starting to crack down on some of their best-known deals after accusations that they're confusing and may encourage us to spend more on the things that we just don't need. However, one person who's found a way to make special offers work to her advantage is Sam Shelford from Essex. Like many of us, she's often to be found staring at her phone. But she's not simply messaging people or indeed checking the latest headlines. She's glued to her phone for very different reasons.
Am I addicted to special offers? I would say I am. Yeah, pretty much. There's many people out there that will sit there browsing the internet or just scrolling through Facebook or just scrolling through Instagram. Now, for me, I actually use that time to look through and find coupons. When I go out and I find a great deal, the sad truth is I actually get a little excited. And obviously, I start to think, how many can I get? How many can I get for free? What if I combine it with this? And all these thoughts start whizzing through my head.
Sam insists that her addiction to discounts saves her a small fortune. Her weekly shop for her family of three costs around £25, less than half the average family spend.
This all started about 3 years ago, just after my daughter was born. We was paying sort of £300-£400 a month on food shopping, and we just couldn't work out where it was going. And obviously, going on maternity leave, not having much of an income, sort of made me realise I needed to tighten our belts a little bit.
When it comes to Sam's main weekly shop, it's all about the bargains. She's determined never to pay full price.
Last year, in a national newspaper, they ran a special offer where you get £5 worth of fruit and vegetables for absolutely nothing in one of the major supermarkets. Now, me being me, I went out and bought 10 newspapers and saved myself £50 on fruit and vegetables that day.
Sam's successes echo those of the coupon kid, Jordan Cox, whom we've met on the programme before.
£82 worth of shopping for 50p.
That's when you were getting good.
Yeah.
Like him, Sam puts a lot of time and effort into finding the best deals, coupons and offers. But it does pay off. She estimates all the hard work saves her family as much as £1,300 a year.
A lot of research does go into finding out the best deals, because I started sort of looking online, looking on social media to see where coupons could be found, how money can be saved, how to budget, you know, general money-saving ideas. It's become a sort of hobby. The main places I sort of tend to find vouchers and coupons is obviously online. A lot of social media will have them, a lot of brands will have them on their websites, getting you to try their products.
Sam has a constant supply of vouchers cut out of magazines, downloaded from the internet, or ripped off packaging. And that's just the start of her homework that she does before going anywhere near a shop.
What I'm going to do now is I'm going to sit and compile a shopping list. I've got my pile of coupons and my tablet, and basically what I'm going to do is work my way through and just see what offers I've currently got in here.
Sam will write a list of all the products she has coupons for. Then she uses price comparison websites to find out who is currently selling those products at the cheapest price. And such meticulous attention to detail is the reason that she ends up saving so much money. This week, she's hoping to bag a load of free soup.
So obviously, one of the key offers was the soup. So when I checked the price comparison site, it had actually been reduced to £1 in store this week. Now I've got £1 off voucher, which actually makes it completely free.
Sam is also a fan of cashback apps on her phone, such as Top Cashback, Checkout Smart, and Shoppertize, all of which, once you've bought particular products, should result in your bank account being credited with the savings that you've made. But while it all sounds a world of opportunity, providing you're prepared, of course, to put the work in, there are those who'd signed a note of caution, particularly to the more casual bargain hunter. So industry expert Darren Smith has called round with some advice.
I'm very keen on coupons and supermarket special offers and obviously their loyalty cards as well. But obviously, what benefit is that to the supermarket if we're getting these good deals?
Supermarkets are a business at the end of the day. So the three things they're trying to do, either get you as a shopper to buy it more frequently. So as an example, Aunt Bessie's launched midweek roast potatoes. So you have a roastie on a Sunday, they're getting you to have one in the week as well. The second thing they're trying to do is increase trip spend, which means when you go in and you spend £1 on a product, they want you to spend £2, so they'll give you a bigger pack. And you might get 2.5 times more, so it's better value for you, but you're spending more with them. And the third thing is trying to get more shoppers to buy into that category or that product. So if you've never bought salads in the winter, they might give you a deal to say, buy this pack in the winter.
And of course, while the supermarkets realise the value of coupons, so too do product manufacturers. For them, the coupons you see as a great deal are simply very clever marketing.
What tricks are actually used to get people enticed to the in-store product?
So what the buyers and the suppliers are trying to do is trying to tempt you here to buy the product, let's call that on the first rung of the stairs. Buy it, you like it, and then when you come back and they roughly know your pattern of buying, 6 weeks later they might get you to buy it again, maybe at a slightly higher price, so you buy more of it. And ultimately what they're trying to get you to do is buy their product often and at full price.
But Sam is confident that she knows exactly how to make the coupons work for her. Despite relying on them for her weekly shop, she's adamant she never buys anything that she doesn't need or indeed won't use. And that's once again the case with the latest haul that she's come back with.
This is a shop that we've just purchased. This here was what we managed to purchase via coupons. Obviously, luckily, the soups, the butter, the yogurts and the hot chocolates were all completely free as well, which is an absolute bonus.
As well as all those freebies, half the items Sam bought were using the cashback app on her phone. So at the store, she'll have paid full price, but now that she's home, she can claim her discount.
In order to claim cashback on these items, what you need to do is you need to open the app itself, scan the barcodes on the relevant items, take a picture of the receipt, ensuring that all items of the receipt are included, and then just upload it, and the app will actually approve the products that you have purchased and apply the cashback to your app.
If she had paid full price, Sam's shopping would have cost her £32.20. But with the coupons, it came to £19.40, a saving of 40%. Sam's addiction to discounts seems to be paying off, because she's even persuaded her own mum to follow her example.
How much do you reckon you've saved in the last couple of years of doing it?
Well, in the last 2 years that I've been doing it, I've saved really about £2,500.
So, are you going to treat me out your savings then, Mum?
Yeah, you must be joking. You've made more than me yourself, so I'll be treating you dead to a holiday.
Supermarket special offers and deals may be coming under increasing scrutiny, but it's unlikely that they'll ever disappear completely. And for Sam, that's just as well, because she couldn't imagine giving up the way that she shops these days.
I don't think I'd ever be able to get out of the routine of actually doing my shopping this way. I just see the massive savings that are made. I enjoy it, I get a little buzz out of it, which is quite sad to say, but no, it'll always be a way of life for me now.
Crowds, queues and heavy shopping bags are just a few of the reasons